that's my topic. Good morning, learned colleagues. Good morning, Apport lecturer, and good morning, technical. Great talk. My name is Godson Mac-Tyger. It was unintentional that this topic recurred again. That simply means that I think God is even telling us that we need to save our planet. I particularly chose this, the monster global warming. This is in consideration to the fact that we are living in a precarious situation. We don't even know what actually as in. So most people are not even aware of the impact. Maybe most people don't know when the Bible says less than 2060 from now, 2050, what the situation will be like. Do we really think we can still exist? Human being is at a threat of extinction if we continue in the same pace. This is my presentation outline, okay? Introduction to global warming. Now, according to Oxford Dictionary defined global warming to be long-term rise in average climate, average temperature of the climate system. It is usually interchangeable with climate change. That's why most of global warming also mean by climate change. I was able to give to come up with very extemporaneous and expanded definition of global warming. I find global warming as the gradual, you cannot note it down anyway, it's a gradual increase in the average temperature. The gradual increase in the average temperature. Which is the gradual increase in the average temperature that is generally attributed to greenhouse effects. Caused by the increase in the level of chlorofluorocarbon, carbon 4 oxide, methane gas, even radioactive elements, due to human anthropocene activity or natural causes. When we talk about anthropocene activity, we are talking about those activities that existed as when human beings started, actively in maybe even industrial participation. You can trace back to industrial participation right from when we had the Industrial Revolution in 1760. That we're talking about when people like John D. Rockefeller started the Industrial Revolution, bringing out crude oil, petroleum products, and so on and so on. The temperature of the world at then is not what we feel now. It has drastically increased. It has increased so much that if we continue at the same rate, our planet is not safe. Now, this actually is the planet Earth's basis. This is already an obliterated or a destroyed planet Earth by increased temperature. This is where it will be if we do not do anything about our emission. Let me go on this. Concept of global warming. Global warming could be caused by fossil fuel emission. He's talking about carbon dioxide, chlorofluorocarbons, radioactive elements, methane, and so on. It all comes down that since we are trying to exist, we are trying to live by inventing things to have a comfortable environment, indirectly we are also harming our environment. Because these gases will definitely be emitted by our production processes to the atmosphere and increases the temperature. So, and if you look at this, this is actually the largest country with the highest rate of fossil fuel emissions is China. China has like 9.5% fossil fuel emission. So, but the US, the United States, and so on. So, it's affecting the entire world. Now, also deforestation. Deforestation also does affect global warming. Because we know we're taking oxygen and give out carbon dioxide, right? I mean, the plant takes in carbon dioxide. So when we now reduce our environment, the plants in the environment, deforestation, when we practice deforestation, there's not enough plants taking this, you know, carbon dioxide. So on that note, it will constitute to the warming of our Earth, planet Earth. Another one is nuclear energy emission. Yeah, I want to launch rockets and so on, nuclear energy emission. Yeah, these radioactive elements, also whenever they move into space, there is a tremendous amount of energy. Talking about, you know, 238s and so on, different elements go into the atmosphere. All these kinds of particulate matters as well. They increase the temperature of the globe. The effect of global warming. Yeah, the effect of global warming. The global warming can be related to droughts, rising sea level. If you look at this, this is like this ice. We all know very well that polar region is it's highest polar and Antarctic region, that's the poles. So when there's an increase in temperature, it will reduce the ice, thereby resulting to flooding. Currently now in the polar region, the temperature then is not what is obtainable now because of the heated environment. So this will result in droughts. Increase temperature will result in droughts, so the ocean will drying up as well. And the atmosphere is heated. We also agree very well that the temperature of before and now is not the same. Okay, we're going to agree on that. There's a few more heat presently than before. But still on this, but also on this, it also threatens our food security. It does threaten our food security in the sense that when there is drought, the vegetation will die. There's no longer vegetation. So food security will also be threatened. So we won't stand the chance of having famine for these consumers. Then again, things like this will also result to extinction of species. There are certain organisms that survive in a certain environment that are no longer there because the ecosystem has changed. So the extinction of species is also one factor. Now, the last species that will exist is human being, you and I. Because if we do not do anything to ameliorate this effect, the point will come when all life will be lost. Control of global warming. Afforestation. Planting of trees encourages the control of global warming. Like I said, plants will take in this carbon dioxide that is using the heat in the environment. Planting of trees will reduce global warming. Not just afforestation, also reforestation. Afforestation, where there are no trees, plants will replant. Where there are the trees before and they are cut down, you will plant other trees. So that also does reduce global warming. Then another one in terms of policy regulation. Policy regulation. There are certain policies that the world, global policies, that the world should imbibe at a tenacious institute to ensure that the environment is being safe. Like currently, the United Nations Framework for Convention and Climate Change, established in 1994, made a Paris Agreement in 2016, which actually brought the level of emitted gas to not more than 2 degrees Celsius. But unfortunately, human beings have doubled that. Now we're having about 4 point something degrees Celsius of emission. Even in spite of that, they're trying to do something about it. So we need to address that issue. If you look at this, this is a very machine, this one she's planting over the end. That's a tree, that one. So planting, we need to plant trees. That does that. Okay, then. Conclusion. So, however, from global warming is indeed the monster, it is ravaging our planet Earth. So, in terms of conclusion, we need to know very well that there is basically nothing we cannot actually stop global warming. It is very unrealistic for everybody to say, oh, yeah, we can stop global warming. Or the world will be static, it's not be heated at any point in time again, or it will reduce in temperature. It will definitely increase. But the issue that is the level at which it increases, we can be able to mitigate or at least live for a longer time, unlike the already predicted time. So if we could carry out some of these measures, proper policies, mostly emphasis on global climate policies would also be very important to save our environment. So, I hereby urge all of us to try as much as possible to be adherent and subservient in ensuring that we save our environment. It is all of us' responsibility and the responsibility of our future generation. Thank you very much. Yeah, sorry. Please ask me a question. Somebody should ask me a question.
Thank you for presentation. Please, can you go back to the slides? Show us my slides. I'm scared. Just go. Let's keep going. This one.
Yes.
Right. Honestly, when I saw this slide, I was scared. And it's obvious that in next probably next century, or 2 centuries from now, who knows what the face of the earth will look like. And you talked about some policies, utility policies that they're supposed to apply, follow, to regulate the way global warming is on increase. I want to ask, what are the measures we can apply to effect these policies? What are we going to do? Because we're just talking, what do we need to do? Yesterday, our beloved lecturer pointed out some, opened my eyes to certain things. Those of us in the government, most times, but nowadays, are not really scientists. So it's difficult for them to understand when you tell them these things. It is that we need to have more scientists go into politics, be called up the top positions in government. So what do we do? It's disturbing. So let me ask the question.
Well, we don't need people to leave whatever they want to study and go into media and so on. The state of government is everybody's responsibility. There should be proper enlightenment. There should be storm to enlighten people on certain things to do. Most especially afforestation, deforestation of the environment. I think that would go a long way. Then we as a whole, even the industrial sector, both the private and the government sector, that deals with combustion, fossil fuel and so on, they should ensure that this emission, they follow the global standard. What has already been meted out by UN, United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, should adhere to it to ensure very well that let everybody globally do that. I think we'll go along with that. Then again, that reminds me, in terms of sequestration, sequestration is also a measure of saving our environment too. Because like I said, sequestration is about storage of carbon dioxide and gas and so on. We know very well that the major consequence of the heat in our globe is carbon dioxide and the other particulate matters and so on. So if we store, because these are gases and carbon dioxide are stored underground, although we have some other means of it, even electrochemical means of reducing, but we can store it, we store them underground, that means they do not get to the, they are not being fed to increase the temperature. So I think that is a very good one, something that we should ensure. So the industrial sector, currently in Nigeria, we do not do anything like sequestration. Most countries do not even do it. It's those well-developed countries that do sequestration. So if this industrial there should be sanctions. You know, the government should also, sanctions should be given to countries that currently now Nigeria is having issues with the United Nations having issues with Iran, because Iran violated some of the sanctions in terms of emission. Even China too, they have reduced it. So sanctions should be given to those countries that do not adhere to these already stipulated rules. So when they break it, there should be sanctions. Sanction. I think that was the first one.
Thank you for your presentation. Because you actually need to highlight one of what the signing on your first slide. Concerning causes of
causes.
No, that is like look at the first slide. When you talk about the flow of carbon as the gas that causes the depletion of the ozone layer, you know? But from your presentation, like talking about holding afforestation. So how do you think you can prevent this flow of carbon from the environment? That's what I'm trying to say. Like which appliance do you think is using this CFC? Because my understanding, this AC is using CFC, your AC output is using CFC. Even your refrigerator are using CFC. And you have like four, five fridges at home. You know how it goes. So what's your recommendation for sending this CFC?
Yeah, that one right. One of the ways we can try to use the global warming is by the invention of low carbon technologies. Now, even the AC here, they use all these things to do it. If we can invent something that probably would reduce the quantity of it, or probably use something, an alternative. That, like what I said very well, I said that it is very unrealistic to think we can stop global warming. You understand? But we can only mitigate global warming, we can only reduce it. Increase our lifespan. Let us live until that end. But we cannot stop it. Because in as much as we want to live a better life, we must use all these things. Even if we intend going to renewable energy, we will still use all these things.
Like now all these old ACs are using RO-containers. Right now they're no longer using all these ACs in the you go to the market, you want to buy AC, you get a lot of containers. Also, when I was doing my MSc, normal UGC, I know someone actually sent me a video about a company in Canada that has produced something that is able to extract the CO2 gas from the environment and process it into fuel. So I actually have that video, but I don't know about if that is actually used right now. But they actually have developed such technology for that, such as chemical thing. Extracting the CO2.
So it's a good old scientist in the background to reduce the carbon.
So that's possible.
So, thank you.